So I think almost everybody knows Apito, at least by name, no? And Estrellanes. So we have the next one is Baktikan. Baktikan is also correct. Okay, so now everybody were cold. So everybody is cold. So there is a whole lot of wood types under medium and still very useful. For example, as flooring. Okay. So, and there are again the last type of wood that I am going to tell you. Moderated low. So we have what? Almasega. I am not familiar with it. Bayo. I am not familiar. Pingulingo. I have some name, recall, familiarity. Mangga Sinoro. Botany. I am not aware of this. Rain tree is somewhat common. And then the moderately low strength. And lastly, Imane. So those are some of the very useful locally produced wood. Locally produced meaning we plant it here in the Philippines to be able to harvest later on the tree or the trunk form of the wood. Let us now familiarize ourselves with the important characteristics. So I already told you that we need modulus of elasticity, shear strength, tensile strength, compressive strength, and flexural strength. Usually, tensile and flexure is specified as one value in the table, and we have four, and then therefore we have this one parallel to the grain, compressive strength, parallel compressive strength, perpendicular. There are times that even the tension property is being measured perpendicular or parallel to the grain. So let us take a look at some of the details of the most commonly used local wood. So for example, in group 1, I will round down on the different types, and let us fill the both of the each and every one of us to suggest the most common, the utilized high strength type of wood. Okay. This is Aguho, Liusin, Malabayabas, Manggat Capuy, Mulabe, Nari, Sasalin, Yakan. So, after hearing that, which one do you think is the most commonly used? Type. Yakan, Nari. Can you give me in your opinion Which one is the most familiar to you? Okay, I will repeat this end. Aguho, liusin, malabayabas, manggatapoy, gulabi, narig, sasalit, and yakal. So which one do you think is the most commonly used high strength type of wood? Which one? Aguho or yakal? Okay, aguho. Consensus. Let us have a consensus. Yakal? Why, maybe yakal, no? Maybe yakal? Do you agree? Sasalit?
Sasalit.
So, maybe sasalit, so... Okay. So, therefore, I hear three names. So, let us vote. Right. Who would like to vote for aguho? So, let's see some hands. One. So, who would like to vote for sasalit? Sasalit. There are two hands. One, two. So, who would like to vote for yakal? So, yakal is the most common of the two hands. Okay? So, our estimation, yakal is... most popular is this group, okay? But in the board exam, these three are usually given in the board examination. So, Masali, very common. Aguho, very common. So, these three. So, we pick one, we pick yakal. And let us look at the property of yakal, okay? So, what is the modulus of elasticity of yakal? Okay. Again, how much?
9.18.
That is in terms of? Gigapascal. 9.18 gigapascal. Okay. So that is very important. So, modulus of elasticity. But another modulus of elasticity, the shear strength. And flexural strength. The tension. What is that? Compression. No? Compression. Parallel to the grain and compression perpendicular to the grain and tension, no? Shear, no? Shear and tension parallel to the grain, no? Shear and tension parallel to the grain and shear, flexure. So I repeat that. It is stipulated that we have the first column is actually flexure and tension. Parallel to the grain, the second column is modulus of elasticity and compressive strength, parallel to the grain, compressive strength, perpendicular to the grain, and lastly shear strength. Okay. So we have five. So, 4, the yakal, you said 9.18, so that is gigapascal, and all the rest is in terms of megapascal, so it's your gigapascal, so this is 4, this is your megapascal. Wait, what about each flexural strength? How much? How much? 20? 4.5.